虽然是小说里中途大陆的人间净土，也是南半球的世外桃源，看起来与世无争的纽西兰，却也挡不住暖化的魔手铺天盖地。 原本是享受壮阔景致的海景第一排，在今年初热带飓风横扫之后，俨然成为海水倒灌的摇滚区。擅长设计永续建筑的纳许，就调整建筑模式来面对以往纽西兰人很陌生的风灾。
The stilts are there to allow you can see this riverbed flowing through, so that's where the water all flows through.
Climate is defining the form of architecture a lot more. We're allowing the landscape to make beautiful buildings.
家就位在风灾重灾区的雷希特，亲眼目睹风灾造成的冲击，决定以毛利人传统的瓦卡独木舟为灵感，准备打造出可以顺应变化的建筑。
The building itself is set upon buoyancy foundations, and that it's able to be risen up with the tides and come down when it needs to.
要设计能抵抗风灾的建筑，得要先了解风灾是如何侵袭这个城市。研究水利工程的专家尝试了解海岸边的情况。 机械工程学系的学者就打造实验室，模拟风灾来袭时的奥克兰。
We have to respond in such a way that we're adaptive as well mid storm, and not just prepared before the storm, but we can adapt while the storm is passing as well. We're talking about forces on buildings, pressures, looking into if we'll have debris from these storms.
不过一旦灾害发生，挽救人民安全是最重要的任务，能争分夺秒，侦测出受害者的位置，就能大幅增加安全脱困的机会。
And it applies AI in a novel way over the top of that image to autonomously detect casualties and target objects. We're working at about a 90% accuracy at the moment, and the more the system is used.
位在苏格兰的新创公司利用科技降低救援的困难度，尤其是长时间在海上，风力发电装置或是钻游平台的工作人员，必须靠这些科技确保安全。
So cold water shock sets in within 3 minutes. You need to get the guys out of the water very, very quickly. When you work in an offshore wind farm, you could be 3, 4, 5 hours from a lifeboat and over 2 hours from a helicopter.
不止关注受困者的安全，研发出能在30秒内把人送上船避免失温的自动装置。救援人员也是重要考量，因此打造远端遥控，前往事发现场展开援助的自动救援船。
So imagine seeing your computer game system and you're controlling the boat from there. That coupled with the cameras around the vessel and the option for mics allow it to be a two-way scenario to allow you to talk to those who are being rescued, but also get that full environmental sense of the situation. This reduces the need for crew to be put at risk to be launched. It allows the captains to go, you know what, I'm going to launch the Guardian anyway, although I won't put more of my crew's lives at risk to rescue that life.
面对极端气候冲击越来越剧烈，天气变化越来越快速，从建筑到救援科技也都在追上脚步，顺应暖化冲击，减少财产，还有人员损失。TVBS新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载TVBS新闻网APP。